Do you know what's the difference between anatomical dead space and physiological dead space? Welcome to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will learn about ventilation and dead spaces in respiratory system. Let's get started. This is simplified diagram of lung. This part represents conducting airway. It's the passage from nose and lips to just before alveoli. This part does not participate in gas exchange. These are alveoli, and these are pulmonary capillaries supplying alveoli. Alveoli participate in gas exchange. Now let's see tidal volume. It's the amount of air that we breathe in and out with each respiration. Normally it's about 500 ml in adults. Ventilation is amount of air that moves in and out of lung in 1 minute. If we multiply tidal volume with frequency of respiration, we get the value of ventilation. Tidal volume of 500 ml at 12 breaths per minute gives ventilation 6 liters per minute. Now, out of this 500 ml air that we breathe in, 350 ml reaches to the alveoli and 150 ml stays in conducting airway. Alveolar ventilation is amount of this fresh air entering in the alveoli every minute. So multiplying this 350 ml with 12 breaths per minute gives alveolar ventilation 4.2 liter per minute. Coming to this 150 ml. As it stays in conducting airway, it does not contribute in gas exchange. So this space is called anatomical dead space. Ventilation of this space is called dead space ventilation. Anatomical dead space of 150 ml multiplied by 12 breaths per minute gives dead space ventilation 1.8 liters per minute. Thus, out of 6 liter fresh air that we breathe every minute, only 4.2 liter enters into the alveoli and is actually useful. Remaining 1.8 liter air ventilates the dead space and is not useful in gas exchange. Please note that I have ignored air that is already there in the airways before starting inspiration to keep the discussion simple. Now, there can be one more type of dead space, that is alveolar dead space. In some pathological conditions, some alveoli do not receive blood supply. They still receive air, but due to lack of blood supply, these alveoli do not contribute in gas exchange. This is called alveolar dead space. Physiological dead space is sum of anatomical dead space and alveolar dead space. Healthy person do not have alveolar dead space, so anatomical and physiological dead spaces are identical. But in some disease, physiological dead space is more than anatomical dead space. This is all about ventilation and dead spaces. If you found this video helpful, please share it with your friends too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.